What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. I got this U.S. boiler Burnham Alta going on. Well, not going on. We got a code of H05, and we got no space heating. Let's take a look under the hood and see what's going on. One of the things I love about the Alta, this little pull-down door tells you what's going on. On the bottom part of this label, lockout, hold, and warning conditions. So right now we have a hold condition of 05, low water flow. But you see that little connection right there? It looks like a small Ethernet port. It's actually an RJ11. With this RJ11 port, we can plug in the US boiler USB connect module and wirelessly connect to this computer, this Alta, and tell us what's going on. All right, I've connected to the USB connect Bluetooth adapter with my iPhone. We have a red hold water flow issue, and more specifically H05.1. It's going to tell you what the error is, low water flow. It's going to tell you that the boiler water flow switch does not detect water flow, which means the switch contact is open when it should be closed. Possible problems: air in the system as number one, number two, a piping issue, number three, boiler flow switch could be defective, number four, we can have a boiler pump issue, number five, we can have a restriction of flow, clogged strainer, for example. So I'm going to take the front cover off, and we're going to take a peek inside this very roomy boiler. So front cover comes off by loosening up these little thumb screws on the front left and front right bottom cover. The front module is hinged. We're gonna undo those little plastic tabs. We're gonna fold this down. We're gonna notice that our igniter cable going to our igniter assembly, wish had a little extra on it. Okay, we can fold this down. Take a look inside this boiler. I can easily get my hands on the brazed plate heat exchanger. I can work on the circulator. I can work on the gas control valve. I can service the heat exchanger. Amazing. Look at how much room is in this boiler. And the best part is it's simple. Now there's a thing called just intuition. You know how something normally sounds. You know that you can just sense what's going on. Now, I know it's a fairly new install, but it's been piped in properly. So we can take that out of the equation. What I didn't hear run is that internal circulator.
That Grundfos UPS 15-78.
I didn't hear that Grundfos work. I'm gonna make sure there's no visible water leaks on anything. I'm gonna remove the screws holding on the access cover. And I'm gonna notice that our igniter cable plugs into that ignition transformer. We're gonna carefully unplug that. I'm gonna put that off to the side. And we're gonna check our fuses. Now, we have three fuses. We have a 15, a 1, and a 0.5 amp fuse on our printed circuit board. This is the motherboard or the main PCB of the boiler. The one all the way on my right, and if you're that orientation, the one on the left, that is the fuse for the internal circulator. Now, just as a heads up, if you ever don't have 24 volts on your low voltage control strip right there, you want to check that fuse right there, that 0.5 amp fuse. That regulates 24 volts to the 24 volt power strip right there, that terminal block. Okay, let's kill power. Let's pull that fuse out, and I can tell it looks a little burnt out right there. All right, so there is that little fuse. I'm going to use my Fluke multimeter. I'm going to set it to continuity, and we're going to check to see if we have continuity there. And sure enough, we don't have continuity on the fuse. OL, open line. Now, the great folks over at US Boiler Burnham, they thought of everything. Behind the front cover, kind of like a takeoff switching relay, you have replacement fuses there. We're gonna grab another replacement fuse, pop that bad boy in there, and get her up and running. Okay, there's that fuse. Let's button her back up and fire up. And before you button her back up, make sure you reconnect the igniter cable to the ignition transformer. Reconnect our ignition cable to the ignition assembly and fire up. Now, when power is restored back to the Alta, we're gonna have a 2-minute air purging sequence, which is indicated by STA10. 2 minutes, and then just be ready to go. All right, let's restore our call for heat. Set it for 70. And we got all systems normal now. We have a supply temperature of 67. Return also 67. We just got our flame icon, not only on our display on the iPhone, but also on the LCD display on the Alta. There is a little bit of a delay, if you notice, between the display on the boiler and the USB Connect app. Slight delay there. So right now we have a rate limit. We have a slow start limit. Let's look at some more data. We have a set point of 140 degrees. Supply temperature 105. We're off by just about a second there. That's phenomenal. Gives us flue temperature. Let's go to controller status. Some data there on the boiler serial number. Let's go to input and output status. We have fan speeds, three-way valve. Right now, our three-way valve is CH, central heating. The boiler pump is on, and the system pump is on. Auxiliary pump is off. Boiler flow switch is closed. And we have 32% on our flame intensity. And right now, we're at 13,600 BTUs as an active heat output. And slowly modulating higher as this bad boy cranks up. Great thing about having a Mod-Con or a modulating condensing boiler, it is the ultimate in hydronic efficiency. And look no further than the US boiler. Their Alta, their Alpine, and their other models, phenomenal workhorses for your home or your office. What's also great about the USB Connect is that I can connect it with the RJ45 to connect it to an Alpine, Aspen, or K2. Or I can connect it directly to a Sage controller using the third supplied cable. It's an RJ45 stray cable as opposed to the split. All these cables are included with the US Boiler USB Connect module.